I'm Ileana Ross Leighton, and I'm chairman of the House Foreign Affairs Committee. And in that capacity, I'm so pleased and so honored and blessed to join arms with my friends, the Iranian American community, to say that we deplore the situation that freedom-loving Iranians are suffering under in this terrible resettlement program from Camp Ashraf to Camp Liberty. What a shame to use the word liberty in what is essentially an a prison. It's the anti-liberty. This should be called Camp Anti-Liberty. In Camp Ashraf, there was a thriving community of freedom seekers whose one desire is to restore Iran to its glory. So to have a democracy, to have freedom, to have respect for human rights, and yet they find themselves shunned, pushed aside, sadly, by our own government and by the Iraqi government, a government that we have helped so much, that we have shed blood and treasure in that country. And now we've seen an unholy alliance between Iraq and Iran. And in the middle, inconveniently for the Iraqi government and for the Iranian regime, are these freedom seekers in Camp Liberty. I have been against the shutting down of Camp Ashraf. I've been against taking that population and putting them anywhere else. There's supposed to be a resettlement program in place. We have seen no such resettlement. No one is in another country, and they've not been afforded the basic decency and liberties that we would give to even detainees who have committed acts against our country. What we have found is that there have been instances daily where handicapped individuals, disabled individuals, have had to walk on hard gravel on the floor in order to get to the facilities of the bathroom. So that goes against all of the codes that we have had in our country to help the disabled be able to march walk from one place to the other. The water is not a good quality water. It's not running water in many of the shelters. There's not enough ventilation. There's not enough vegetation. And the residents of Camp Ashraf, the residents now, many of them at Camp Liberty, they have said, let us work on this camp. We can fix it up. So they're not asking for money. They're not asking for supplies. They're not asking for anything other than being given the chance to improve their living conditions so that they can have shelter that is livable. Many of them are not getting the medical attention that they need. So when you talk about the basics that you need, and that's good water, good sanitation facilities, make sure that the disabled are cared for, medical attention, none of those amenities are they being afforded. And that's why we are demanding and demanding and demanding that our State Department take action in a very humanitarian way to let the residents of Camp Liberty refurbish their own facilities and make sure that we do not continue with this forced relocation of the Camp Ashraf residents. That has been their home for a long time, and it's wrong to disengage them from their home where there's safety and security. The residents at Camp Liberty do not feel safe and secure there because they know that the Iraqi government wants to do away with this structure. They don't want this facility, and so they're making it very difficult for the residents to stay there. So we in Congress are committed to doing everything we can to ensure humanitarian treatment for the residents of Camp Liberty, to stop further relocation from the residents of Camp Ashraf, to work with our international partners to see where we can find a place, a country that can accept these freedom seekers. And these are very peaceful individuals. They don't cause any harm. They're very pro-American. They're patriotic. They love this country, and they love the principles of freedom, democracy, the rule of law. What they don't like are the ruling mullahs in Iran, mullahs that want to strangle the people and who only want to maintain in power, themselves in power, and they don't care one bit about the people of Iran. So let's do the things right. Let's bring justice and let's bring closure to this humanitarian catastrophe that is going on in Camp Liberty. Let's all work together and make it happen. And that's why I'm so happy that we have gotten dozens and dozens and dozens of members of Congress to have signed our letter asking for this and more, for justice, for better treatment, for humanitarian concerns being addressed. And we've addressed this letter to Secretary of State Clinton, and we're pleading with her openly and in a very direct way to have compassion with the residents of Camp Ashraf and the residents of Camp Liberty. And it's already time to close the letter, and I'm ashamed to close it out because every day we get more phone calls from members of Congress in a bipartisan way who say that they want to sign the letter to help bring justice to the long-suffering residents of Camp Ashraf and now Camp Liberty. We will continue the fight.